I was going home, and when I got to my building, this lady was running away from me. Like, she thought I was gonna rob her, when I was actually going to my apartment.
People look at me weirdly just because, you know, I wear a scarf on my head, so they would think I'm a terrorist.
Well, I got bullied last year, so I felt like my teacher and all the people who were bullying me, I felt that's how I felt.
Do you feel like the bullying was racially motivated?
Definitely, definitely so. It's one thing to be bullied amongst your own peers, but to be bullied by an adult as well, it's very, very sad.
I had a white teacher, but she would always treat me differently and stuff from other kids just because how I act and stuff, but I always felt it was wrong when I see other kids do the same thing I did and she wouldn't say nothing.
Have you ever experienced racism in your daily life?
No, I haven't.
You've never experienced racism?
No, not yet.
Do you think that racism is a problem in America?
Yes.
Can you tell me why?
Some people would be ignorant.
Oh, yeah, I have. I have, like, but it doesn't really bother me because, like I said, just the way that I was raised to believe that, you know, homosexual relationships are wrong, I do see it as, you know, people that, you know, are racist or prejudiced against other people. That's just how they were raised as well.
Have you ever faced discrimination?
Yeah, I have.
Can you tell me about it?
I prefer not to, but
a lot of my friends used to refer to me as, like, you know, they say I used to act white or, you know, because I'm black or whatever, but they used to say, you know, you have that white girl talk because I was proper.
I mean, as you can see, like, I'm not, like, a normal black person. So a lot of them expect me to sag my pants and, like, know all the hip-hop they're talking about, but all I want to do is just rock out to some metal, some punk rock.
Not everywhere, you know, I feel like definitely somewhere it's more priority for the white race.
In general, yes. There could be cases where that's not, but definitely yes.
I think, like, minorities have made a lot of progress, but because where they come from, that's kind of, like, they don't take those opportunities as much as a white person would, where, say, a white person's family is more likely to push them to achieve higher things, while a minority, in some cases, they're more likely to settle.
Like, if you have parents that are, like, doctors or, like, really, like, have been to university who, like, are tutoring their children every day after school, like, I know my mom did that with me when I was growing up. But then some families where, like, both the parents are working all day, they don't have as much, it's, like, a larger family, or, like, they don't have as much time to spend with individual attention to their children.
There's some essay questions, and one of them is, like, what do you like to do? Like, what interests you? What do you like to do for fun? And, you know, the kids, again, they write, oh, I build rocket ships and genotype and, like, make genetically modified foods. But what about the kid that spends all their time, like, babysitting to earn money? That doesn't mean that that student is not capable of excelling at, like, a science school.
No, I don't think so.
Can you tell me why?
Because it's really called racism, and it's really bad.
Not everyone is on the same level of privilege, and other people kind of need more of, like, kind of like a boost to kind of, like, get on the same level as others that have it easier.
I mean, I guess the intention is right, but I don't like it because, I mean, I'm a minority, so it feels like I'm being babied.
Everyone comes here for America because it's, like, the land of opportunity. They shouldn't, like, be, getting jobs shouldn't be based on race.
I don't believe that affirmative action in the state it's in right now should be continued because I know plenty of black or Hispanic or Asian rich people, so it should be affirmative action in a social status.
I think affirmative action at a time was helpful, but I think our laws have moved beyond that. We've elected a black president. I think it served its purpose.
Racism is less prevalent in society than it was in, like, the 60s, but really, that's not saying much. Like, I could get attacked just for being outside, like, in the 60s.
I was in the Marine Corps, and I kind of saw the bigotry in the Marine Corps when the whole election was coming up, and it wasn't even about the issues.
I think it has improved. It's not really that big of an issue anymore.
Racism, it still exists, but it's not, you know, widely an area that needs to be discussed, so I don't feel like that's something that's important in today's time.
when they say racism happened a long time ago or segregation, and it's not a long time ago. You know, I mean, a lot of younger people have no concept of time. Just because people have made laws against things and, you know, it's all quiet now doesn't mean it's gone away.
Yeah, post-racial society is not a thing. It's like, absolutely not. There's all kinds of implicit biases. And even if you are not racist, you know, you have all these biases and there's nothing you can do about it.
Martin Luther King, Constitution,
equality, war,
justice,
history.
Yeah, history.
Racism,
inequality,
revolution,
equal,
voting,
like freedom.